What's up, everybody? Haven't said hello in a while, and I'm in between appointments, so I figured now might be a good time to go ahead and do so. Forgive the mysterious mood lighting. I'm parked in a garage. Let's go ahead and jump into this. I ran across an ad recently on Instagram, and I thought, wow, what a great example of some of the best practices that I teach inside of the Art of Hustle coursework. So I just wanted to introduce you to a couple elements, and despite its simplicity, how it links back to concepts and frameworks that are really important in your marketing and communication. So number one, this is a testimonial. Testimonials obviously are important for a number of reasons. And inside of the Art of Hustle universe, we teach you how to gather these testimonials in a specific lesson titled Requesting Reviews. And believe it or not, there is a way to ask that makes it possible for you to rack them up in such a way that is in alignment with your values and the values of your customers. The testimonial itself is obviously useful in this example inside of an ad, but it's also going to function really well on your website. Now, a testimonial isn't the only thing you want appearing on your website. There are five essential ingredients that everybody needs to include when creating a landing page. If you're not familiar with that concept, a landing page, long story short, is where you want people to land after you share a link, and that could be any number of places online, but in the most common example, it would be the homepage of your website, right? So if you don't have these five essential ingredients, one of them is testimonials, your landing page probably isn't working as best as it could. And what does that mean for you? That means visitors drop in and then they bounce right out. That's not good. Notice how in this particular ad, the company that created it names its primary competitor. This is really effective in some ways because it gives the viewer and or reader immediate insight into what industry you're representing, and it also positions you as a potential smart alternative to an already very popular brand. So this is very strategic and intelligent. This is something that I speak with my members and clients in a lesson called Targeting Your Ideal Client. Number one, to identify who your customer is, and more important after the fact is how to craft a value proposition that makes the most sense. In one of the versions that I teach, we talk about how it might be a smart move to name one of your primary competitors. So one of the most important things I want to leave you with before we close out here is when things are working out really well, they look super simple. Like this ad is super simple. There's not a lot going on in it, visually speaking, right? But behind the scenes, the intention behind it, the intelligence that goes into crafting an ad like this, there is actually a lot. If you want to make the most out of your existing assets and all the work that you're already doing to promote yourself and or the name of your company, then hit me up and learn all these basics, right? Because otherwise you could look an ad like this, try to duplicate it and do it all wrong. That's a waste of time. That's a waste of resources. And it can be very disheartening going about it the wrong way and not knowing why things aren't working. So just some things for consideration there. If you want to talk more about this, hit me up. Holler at me. Again, my name is Anthem Salgado, business coach representing Art of Hustle, now in our 11th year. Peace.